Yes, sweetheart.
My question is if I could please do some work with you around cancer.
Angel, let's get it on.
Thank you.
Let's rock and roll. Well, sweetheart, it's what is. Crying is good. So as it comes up, all I would ask of you is to let it have its own life, its own energy, and just open your throat and open your mouth and just let it have its own life. It's not you.
Thank you. God, very sweet.
What is your first name?
My name is Judith.
Judith, welcome to the work, Angel.
Thank you.
So let's begin at the top. Sweet friend.
Who or what don't you like? Who irritates you? Who or what saddens or disappoints you? I don't like or am saddened, angry, confused, etc. at name cancer. I don't like the cancer. The cancer disables me. I'm scared. 3 times is too much.
Okay. So where you have the word cancer, put the word thinking and turn it around. I don't like my thinking.
I don't like my thinking. My thinking disturbs me. I'm scared of my thinking. 3 times thinking is too much. My thinking is too much.
Isn't that as truer? Cancer never did that much pain to anyone.
The distinction that I'm having a difficult time with is I see so many blessings. They are just innumerable, and I'm so grateful. But there's a place that I take myself that I just destroy myself with the thinking.
Yeah.
And I've begun not to like myself.
Thinking is just something to write down and investigate. That's all. So, cancer is an outside source. The body is an outside source. So every time you focus on an outside source, you're going to feel this terror, because the thinking is going to do everything it can to make a story to be investigated. It's like a magnet you attach to it, all around an apparent outside source. Who would you be without your story, without your cancer story? Who would you be without your story? And I'm not asking you to give it up.
I would be less afraid.
I would go with that.
I'd be less afraid.
Yes.
I'd be less afraid.
Cancer thrives on fear. Fear is cancer. Can you see a reason to stop focusing on cancer, an outside source? For all you know, you don't even have it right now. You can't know that.
I don't. I mean, I just had surgery, so I know that I mean.
Well, you know, it doesn't matter. You just can't know in this moment.
Mm-hmm. I get it.
And I'm not asking you to go into this denial thing. I'm just saying. Can you see a reason to drop the cancer story?
Yes.
Can you see a reason to keep it, other than pain and suffering?
No. No.
My experience. In the peace of that, you know where to go, what to do, you sleep well, you're clear. The story would keep you from harmony. Let's look at the next one.
How do you want them to change? What do you want them to do, Judith? Be more self-accepting, loving, accepting of the circumstances, be in the now.
Yeah. So you're supposed to be in the now. What's the reality of it?
I flip back and forth.
Yeah, sometimes you're not. And what do you get when you hold the belief that you're supposed to be in the now when you're not?
I don't get peace.
Yeah, you get to think that now is a future to get to. I'll be in the now later. It's impossible. Yeah, that's what we get for holding the belief. Becomes a destination.
Could you say that again, please? That last part.
So what do you get for holding the belief that you're supposed to be in the now when you're not?
You I don't get to be in the now.
Yes.
Thank you.
You get the now in a future.
I see.
That never comes.
Okay.
We can't have what we want. We already have what we want. What we want is what is. When we tell another story about that, it's to keep us from the awareness of it, and it's always up the road, and there is no up the road, this is it. So we're always living in a fantasy, in the wants.
In.
Who would you be without the story that you're supposed to be in the now?
At peace with what is.
So who would you be without the story? Peace. You see, cancer is a thing that it takes, you know, one of the stories is it's like it takes over. Well, that's what the thinking does when it focuses outside of itself. It's a mirror image of itself. It's a mirror image of chaos and uninvestigated. Let's look at the next one. People are not supposed to have cancer, is it true? Do we have it? People are not supposed to physically suffer. Is it true? Do people physically suffer? Human beings are not supposed to suffer physically. Not on this planet. We do. What do you get when you hold the belief we're not supposed to suffer?
Suffering.
So your suffering looks like this. You hold the belief you're not supposed to suffer, and it looks like that. So what happens to pain? It intensifies. So now you've got suffering over the suffering. And you can't do the work when you're in physical suffering. You know, just give me morphine. Forget the spiritual crap. But on the other side of the morphine, do the work. The next time you're in pain, you may notice something quite different. People may say, you look so fatigued. And you may say, oh, well, that's not my experience. I forgot to be fatigued. You know, you are where you are perfectly in joy. Sweetheart, let's look at the next one.
What is it that should or shouldn't do, think or feel, named cancer? Should go away, shouldn't take my life.
Is that true? In this dream, they say cancer takes our life. Okay, and then the bodies die and we bury them. That's it. So what do you get for holding the belief that you know more than God, you know more than what is, that you're not supposed to have cancer and die? What do you get from that story?
I get that God didn't die and put me in charge of knowing.
How does that feel?
I believe that. I sometimes can't hold on to it.
Well, sweetheart, we just do the work instead. It's not a belief, this is a reality. What do you get when you hold the belief you are not supposed to die of cancer?
Peace. peace? That I'm not supposed to, I get acceptance.
When you have the belief you're not supposed to die of cancer?
That I'm not supposed to, I don't believe it at times.
Well, I'm not asking about what you believe.
I'm sorry.
Okay. The reality is some of us die of cancer.
Right.
It doesn't mean you're one of them.
Right.
But that's what is.
Right.
You know, in the story, that's what is.
Right.
So have you ever had the thought that you're not supposed to die of cancer?
Oh, I understand what you
mean. Yeah.
Yes, I have.
And what do you experience when you have that thought? I'm going to die of cancer and I'm not supposed to. I don't want to.
Horrible unpeace.
Terror?
Terror. That's the word, terror.
Because it's a lie.
Mm-hmm.
We can't know
right
what is, except just right now. So the purpose of that story is to bury us before we're buried. You know, always living at our own funeral. So can you see a reason to drop the belief that I'm not supposed to die of cancer?
Yes, I can.
It's easier to die of cancer than to hold that one.
Yes.
I mean, cancer is merciful. These mental concepts we attach to, that is, the reality is kind, the illusion, the story, that's where cancer is. Uninvestigated story. Reality was never unkind. But the story would keep us from knowing that. Cancer is love. God is everything, but not cancer, no. God is everything. It's good. You know, I look forward to cancer. Look forward to, you know, like I have a choice. I look forward to death, like I have a choice. You know, I'm just tired of this mental pain. You know, again, reality was never as harsh as what went on in my head before I met it with some understanding. And the same concepts still move through. It's just, they're not real. It's, my children and I have made friends with each other, all 1 trillion of them.
Hmm.
It's called love. I've met them with understanding and in that place we're equal. No higher, no lower. So, Angel,
do you need anything from them? What do you need to give you or do for you to be happy, Judith? Compassion, mercy, acceptance.
So I need cancer to give me compassion, mercy, and acceptance?
Oh, no, I put my name Judith.
Okay. So the only way I know how to give me compassion and mercy and acceptance is to do the work, is to put the nightmare down on paper and investigate it until I can see cancer as my friend. My work's not done until I can see it fearlessly, every concept around it. My work's not done. I mean, that's what cancer's for. Can you befriend that? Can you love that? Without condition. My body is not my business. Cancer is not my business. My thinking is my business. That's it. Let's look at the next one.
What do you think of them? Make a list, Judith. I'm afraid that I've recreated my illness.
People recreate their cancer. Can you really know that that's true? That's such a good one. If you were more spiritual, you wouldn't have cancer. Obviously, you failed. Oh, my. Some of us have gone there, to that place I named. Mm-hmm. You've recreated your cancer. Can you really know that that's true?
No.
What do you get for holding that belief?
Shame and guilt.
Can you see a reason to drop it?
Absolutely.
Can you see a reason to keep it?
No.
I have recreated, I mean, God has nothing to do with this. The is has nothing to do with this. Nothing. I recreated my cancer.
I really do have a different conversation about that. And I really do have a conversation of the mystery of God and life about that.
Yes.
It comes back. It really seems to be a very pervasive conversation. I'm so grateful that someone doesn't have that conversation. I thank you for not having that conversation, because I truly don't have that for someone else. And it comes back to me, and I feel guilty, and perhaps I didn't do enough.
You don't recreate or create anything except a story, in my experience.
Mm-hmm.
You are the is, in my experience. Perfectly, perfectly. No arms, no legs, arms, legs, cancer, no cancer. You are the is. You are what is. The story would argue with it, to keep you from the awareness of it. It's the obstacle that keeps you from awareness. So just let the work be your breakfast if you think it would serve you. Let this work be your breakfast, your lunch, your dinner. And not to heal cancer. You know, to do the work with the motive of healing a body is, you know, you get the perfect body, you get it all healed, and you get a divorce, you know, or a truck hits you. No, we just want peace.
Thank you.
Welcome.
What is it that you don't ever want to experience with that person, thing, or situation again?
Sweetheart, let's turn that one around. I created my cancer. Turn it around.
I did not create my cancer. I'm living in the mystery of life and death.
It's a mystery. Is that true?
Is it a mystery?
You live or you die. That's it.
Oh. Well,
and even that's a story.
Well,
can I ask you? The mystery of our thinking. You know,
the mystery,
is uninvestigated thinking. An uninvestigated story. Investigate it, no more mystery.
Like
people say, what is the secret of life? Why am I here? It's simple, because you are. That's it. What is, is.
What is, and I don't know. I mean, is that what you said? You know, what is, and I don't know the reason, and just live in the now with it.
I'm alive, yep, checking it out.
Mm-hmm.
And when I'm dead, there's nothing to check out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we only have to know about one of those. Not the mystery of life and death, just... that half of it solved.
Thank you. What is it that you don't ever want to experience with the person, thing, or situation again? I don't want to, or I refuse to, dislike myself. I refuse to give in to the cancer. I don't want to experience the fear.
Okay. I'm willing.
I'm willing.
And read it the way you wrote it.
I refuse to dislike myself.
I'm willing to dislike.
Oh, excuse me. I'm willing to...
already much freer. Yeah.
Yes. I'm willing to dislike myself.
Isn't that the end of fatigue in the moment? It goes from like this to this. So I'm willing.
I'm willing to dislike myself. I'm willing to refuse to give in to the cancer.
Yes.
I'm willing to want to experience the fear.
Yes. I look forward to.
I look forward to it.
Yeah. Good. We don't even have to be aware, like, or disciplined, like, be disciplined. And when you're out of your business, you don't have to be disciplined. There's a built-in mechanism to let you know. It's called a feeling. Well, this doesn't take anything. Everything you need is built in. When you feel afraid or uncomfortable, find the story that you're in or the one that you were in just before that. Write it down and realize yourself. Realize for yourself. For yourself. Not doctors, not society, not the news. Realize for yourself. We have been taking people's word for everything. They say, that's the sun. Okay. That's the moon. Okay. Well, that's the sky. None of that is my experience. There is no way that anyone... There's no way that can be a moon for me again, or a sun, or a sky. The investigation wouldn't allow that. When we begin to investigate, it's over for taking people's word for anything. It's like beginning at 2 or 3 years old again. Like, it's a beautiful day. Oh. Well, not for me. I say, good. And I'll even say, oh, it's a gorgeous day. People love that stuff. It's not going to make it so. Nothing can compete with what that story, that the attachment to that uninvestigated story, nothing, no story could compete with the internal joy that we are already. So know for yourself. Realize yourself for yourself. And you do very well at that. I created my cancer. Well, that was a good one. That's a good one. How powerful are you? It's just one more story. Just one more story to stay focused on so you don't have to live before you die, even if it's 90. 100. We can't know anything. A child that dies at 3 months old has lived a full life. That's what it is. I love you, Judith.
Thank you, and I love you also for bringing such a beautiful clarity to something that I really did believe but really had not had spoken.
Yes.
And to have that spoken and made real for me is such a blessing, and I thank you.
Welcome, sweetheart. It's very fine to hear what you already know. I'm you, sweetheart. I'm your voice.
Oh.
It's the same. It's the same.
Did I insult you?
It's not possible.
Oh, thank God.
It's not possible.
Thank you.
Oh, sweetheart. Oh, my. That's like I created cancer. You can insult someone. Is it true?
No.
That's not possible.
No, I don't have that much.
You say something, and I tell the story about how that's insulting, and I insult me with my own story, not what you said.
God bless you. Thank you.
And only in that do people not have the power to insult anyone. I tell the story of what you said, and I insult me, and that's the name of that tune. I dance to my own song.
Thank you.
Welcome, Angel.
Thank you very much.
thoughts, questions? As we do this work, if you put your own disease on it, a parent disease on it, or your own, it could even be a relationship, you know? It can be as painful as this. If you meet your story with understanding and compassion, there is no one that can come to you with any story that you cannot meet the same way. If you have investigated the stories within you, no one can bring you a story you haven't worked with. So to befriend what arises is to befriend the entire body. You may as well, it's your body.
About the cancer where she said she was thinking she recreated that, can our thinking create physical problems in our body?
A feeling is an effect. Cause is a story. I'll call it that. That's duality.
Yeah.
And when you come to see the internal cause, the story, effect, the feeling, you come to see it, it puts you in a space above duality, where there is no cause or effect, not even cause. It puts you prior to cause. When you come to understand the illusion, the story, then there's a re-entry, and it's nothing more than its self as itself, equal to, no duality. So if I think that I recreated my own cancer, if I hold that story without investigation, these feelings, the effect of the story, these feelings are going to be like this until it gets my attention. So who can heal like this? The investigation opens it up. You see? And I have no interest in people's physical health. What good is it? You know, well, I don't bother going. I understand people like that. But we want something more. We want something more. Even at our best, someone can just look at us cross-eyed and we go, oh my God. You know, and we go into some kind of story about what that means. So we cannot even enjoy a pleasant physical health. We just want more. So in my story, I could have cancer and never have it and just live in doctor's offices. I know that I went and they put my blood up on a screen 12 years ago and the doctor was looking at the screen just, you know, oh my God, I don't see how you're alive. Oh my God, look at the cancer cells. Oh my, and he was just doing all of this number, and I'm looking at this same screen going, oh my God, look at the life. It was beautiful. He's seeing death, you know, get a clue. Everything was moving in there. It was beautiful. So I just went with, you know, he could be right, and look at the life.
Yeah, it was that sentence, body follows mind, that I...
Body follows mind.
How far can that go, you know?
I think, feel, act, have. That's duality. That is time, space, and place. As long as you have a story, it has to hit the next one to keep the first lie up. You investigate, the lie falls. Quiet, realization. That is the ultimate addiction, freedom, peace, truth, the heart, God. It will have itself back. It is too greedy not to. Was lost out there 43 years with no way back, and this investigation became alive in me. It was natural. It's natural in all of us. I'm finding all over the world. So we come back, and now it's a circle. It doesn't just stay. It never left. It just loves the trip. It is itself. It's just meeting it with some understanding. Not a denial. Yeah.
So no mind, no body, that's not separate anymore then. At that stage, it's not separate.
No.
Thank you, Kitty.
Welcome, Inja.
Last week I was thinking about you coming here, and the only question that came up in my meditation was, Katie, please teach me how to die. Uh-huh. And it came from the heart. And I realized today just allowing that to arise is the death, and it's the answer to how to die.
Yes.
And you just said it's the answer to life.
Yes.
So thank you.
Welcome.